everyone, welcome back to my channel. For today's tutorial, I wanted to do something a little bit more edgy, so I came up with this ponytail. I'm sure I saw it somewhere and it inspired me somehow, but I hope you enjoy the video. Make sure to like and subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads, and let's get started. To start this hairstyle, I'm going to begin by creating a fishtail fringe braid along the top of my head. So I'm going to divide off a section of hair at the hairline right above my forehead and divide this into three smaller pieces for my braid. I'm going to do one stitch of a fringe braid, so I'm just crossing the side strands over the middle strand. Then I'm going to combine the middle and right strand together and switch to a fishtail fringe braid. So to do this braid, I'm just going to take small sections from one side and cross them over to the opposite side. And I'm also going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid at the same time. So I'm just going to pick up sections of hair from right under the braid, keeping them along the center of my head, and bring them into my braid. So I'm just crossing small sections from one side over to the opposite side, picking up new sections of hair from right under the braid, and crossing them over to the opposite side as well, and just working my way along the center of the top of my head back towards the crown of my head. Then I'm going to continue the braid down the back of my head until it reaches about the center of my head. And once the braid reaches the center of the back of my head, I'm going to stop bringing in sections and clip off the braid to use later on. You basically want to stop the braid where you plan on placing your ponytail. This will make it easier to wrap it all together when you're done. So once that braid is done, I'm going to create another fringe braid with the hair on the right side. So I'm going to pick up a section of hair near the hairline and divide it into three smaller pieces. I'm going to be crossing the side strands over the center strand again. And then after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to begin incorporating new sections of hair into the braid like before. So I'm just picking up small pieces of hair and crossing them over the middle strand, bringing them into the braid. And I'm going to be braiding the hair along the right side of my head, keeping it higher on my head. I want my ponytail to sit at the center back of my head, and it'll be easier to bring the braids into the ponytail if they kind of line up with where the hairband and ponytail will sit. So I'm just continuing the braid, bringing in small sections of hair from along the top of the braid and from along my hairline until I've brought in hair from behind my right ear. Then I'm just going to stop incorporating hair into the braid and continue the braid a little further down before sliding a couple bobby pins over the bottom to keep the braid from unraveling. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create another fringe braid with the hair on the left side of my head. This will be the third and final braid in the hairstyle. So I'm just doing the exact same process as the two previous braids, picking up a section near the hairline, dividing it into three pieces, and crossing the side strands over the middle. And I'm incorporating new sections of hair into the braid like before, trailing the braid along the left side of my head, keeping it a little bit higher so it goes into the ponytail more easily. Then when all of the braids are done, I'm going to combine all of my hair together, including the ends from all three braids, and tie it all together using a hairband. And once it's all tied off, then I can remove the bobby pins from the ends of the braids. Then I'm going to go back over the top braid and just gently pull on the edges and small sections. I want to add a little bit of height to this braid. You don't need to do this, but I like to do it just to help balance out the hair that's on top of my head. And then of course I covered the hairband with a piece of hair, so I just wrapped it around the hairband and then I pinned it underneath using a bobby pin. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure to like and subscribe and click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads. And I will see you next time.